start.
Okay.
How?
Well, hello all. This is another topic in equilibrium. When we talk about equilibrium, already we had a discussion of three conditions of equilibrium called summation M0, summation FX0, and summation FY0. These are called as conditions of equilibrium for non-concurrent force system called general force system. And when it is concurrent, we have only two equilibrium conditions called FX0 and summation FY0. Today, we are going to talk about special equilibrium problems on beams. So when I talk about beams, what beam is? Beams are the slender members which are subjected to loading always perpendicular to transverse directions. Now what I said is slender member, not cylinder. What it means a slender? If you talk about its width or a thickness, that's a depth. These two dimensions are very less as compared to its length, longitudinal axis. So such a member is called as a slender. For example, I can say this chalk as a slender, but piece is not a slender because earlier the dimension, which is the length, is very high compared to its cross-sectional dimensions. And it is a horizontal slender member which is subjected to loading always perpendicular to longitudinal axis. So it may be this way or this way. So these directions are called as transverse directions. So going ahead with the definition, when we discuss about beam, the three important parts are, we must know what are the types of supports. So let us go with the first part of type of supports. Then we should understand what are the types of loads, and then important part is types of beams. So let us go with the first part called types of supports. When we talk about types of supports, there are different types of supports. Few are in SPPU syllabus, few are in other. Like when I talk about the first one, it is called a roller support. The roller supports, symbolically, they are mentioned like this. So this is a beam. Whenever I draw such a line, it is called a beam. And see, the rollers are resting on a horizontal floor. It can be another way. It is shown just a roller supported with a beam, and the rollers are resting on a horizontal floor. Sometimes the rollers are resting on an inclined plane, which is inclined to some angle, say theta with horizontal, and they are supporting to a beam. So these are the three different ways we can show the beam, the support. Now roller support has only water reaction, which is always perpendicular, normal to the surface on which they are resting. So it has only water reaction. In a similar way, when we go for another type of support, it is called as hinge support, or which is also called as a pin support. Pin support is shown this way. This is the symbolical representation, or it can be shown inclined. But whether it is resting on a horizontal floor or inclined floor, might well, it has two components of a single inclined reaction. One component is in the y direction. So generally in some of the universities, it is represented as AY, being support is A, and another reaction which is in a horizontal direction is AX. So AX and AY are the two components. Even now here the supports are inclined, they are not like this because the reaction is inclined. So this also has a reaction, say horizontal vertical reaction and a horizontal reaction. So such two components of a single reactions are there for hinge or a pin support. Why it is called as a pin support? Because sometimes the two beams are joined by a pin, so it can be able to rotate. It has no reaction to the movement. Like in the earlier case, when it was roller, see what happens when the rollers are resting on the inclination or horizontal floor. Because of the loading applied, can be vertical or inclined, the reaction exerted by the support, because the rollers are resting on the support, so it has only one reaction. Whereas if I make an attempt, if I make an attempt for a roller, that those rollers are resting, and so load is applied, it may move horizontally, rightward or leftward. So in that case, there is no restriction, there is no reaction exerted to the horizontal component of the inclined force or horizontal force. So it has no component in the horizontal direction. Whereas when we talk about the hinge or a pin support, which is shown like this, what happens is it is somewhat like it is pinned there. So it will resist to the vertical applied load, so there is a vertical reaction. And if I make an attempt that it should go, or if I make an attempt to apply the force in horizontal direction, there will be a horizontal reaction. So such a beam with maybe say inclined load, so to this there are two components. So this will be resisted or reacted by vertical component, and this will be reacted by the horizontal component. But the limitation is, being it is a hinge or a pin, if the load is applied at some distance like this, there are chances that it will rotate like this. Or if this is the support, it will rotate. So there is no moment reaction exerted by the hinge support. Whereas in case of the third one, what we are saying is a fixed support. What happens is, in fixed support, symbolically it is represented like this. And whatever the type of loading, it can be UDL, which we are going to see later on. Say it is a point load, so it has three components of the reaction, one in the y direction, one in the x direction. And what happens with the moment or a force is applied at some distance, because of which there is a moment get created, it will be resisted by a moment reaction, so it is represented as MA. So considered as this as the support A. Like if this is the say fixed support, so if a force is applied to this applied action, there is going to be a reaction in a vertical direction. To this horizontal applied force, there is a horizontal reaction. And if the moment is applied, earlier in case of pin it was not resisted, but now being it is a fixed support, see this action will be resisted by a movement reaction. So such a type of support has three reactions. Whereas in addition to this, the other supports are either they are called as slotted joint, more correctly, like to a vertical plate or to any of the gusset plate, there is a slot, and in that slot a member is connected with nut and screws, and which will be able to move along the slot. So there is only one reaction always, which is perpendicular to the slot, normal to the slot. So slotted joint has only one reaction, whereas the last type which used to take it is collar support. So in a collar support, there is a rod on which a collar is moving, such a collar which is joined to another member. So because of this, whatever may be the angle, this collar is moving on this rod, and it will have upper or lower motion. Say if it is fixed here, so collar will be radially, it is moving inward or outward, and it is also having the motion at some angle theta. So such a type of support has only one reaction, which is always perpendicular to the rod. So there is a reaction either this way or in the opposite direction, but it is normal, it is perpendicular to the support. So what we have seen is the five type of supports, right from say it is a roller support which has only one reaction, hinge support which has two reactions, then it is fixed support which has three reactions, slotted and collar has only one reaction, slotted has only one reaction perpendicular to the slot, and collar has only one reaction perpendicular to the rod. Now let us go for the second type, what is called as types of loads. So in type of load, first type of load is called as a point or concentrated load. So as they are assumed to be acting on a point load, suppose this is a horizontal beam which is supported by two types of supports. Say it is a simple support. Yeah, one more type of support has left, and that is the simple support, wherein the beam is simply kept on the supports. It can be a column, it can be a beam, and maybe it is a simply kept. This type of support is called simple support, and this simple support has only one reaction, which is always vertical and perpendicular to the beam. So vertical reaction is there. So beam, both the supports are simple support. And say there is a load applied at a point at some distance, maybe 1 meter from the support A. So this is called point load. Actually, there is a concept in idealization. In the first lecture, we have seen what is point is. It is the assumption that the loads are acting at a point. Actually, they are not. Being they are concentrated, or they are supposed to be concentrated at a point, it is called as a point load. Then another type of load is UDL, uniformly distributed load. What happens, say it is a simply supported beam which is subject to a load of